Hello, I'm Patrick Childress. This is video number 2 on anemometers. In the first anemometer, we took apart the lower housing that attaches to the cups to get to the bearings. We showed you how to get the bearings out, clean them up, lubricate them, and reassemble everything. Now we're going to get to the batteries inside of this housing in case they ever need replacing. This is the original Tacktick instrument. In 2011, Raymarine bought out Tacktick. We've never had any problems with our Raymarine equipment, even though it dragged through the South Pacific Ocean for several hundred miles while we're dismasted. And it actually gave us through the water speed that was just as accurate as all of our two other through the water speed indicators. So they're very durable, just have to take care of the bearings, occasionally lubricating them, but we'll get to the batteries right now. And to get to those, you make it easy for working on it. We'll take out the one screw that mounts the mounting shaft, and I'm going to pry out the bearing housing. We'll get that out of the way, make it easier to work on. Okay, it just snaps in place. Now, before we take this apart, I'm going to mark with a magic marker where everything aligns, because there's little cutouts here so you can pry up with a screwdriver and realign things with the ears upon reassembly. And I'm going to mark on the back side here where the mount is, so you don't flop things 180 degrees. Okay, now there's 4 screws. 1, 2, 3, 4. Sometimes you might have a sticky decal around covering these holes. So you're going to have to feel around and poke into those holes to find out where the screw holes are. Now these are number 16 Torx screw heads. A Phillips head, a hex head screw screwdriver, nothing is going to work but a number 16 Torx. So I've already loosened up all of those screws in here, but I'm just going to double check, make sure. Okay, now the hard part is prying out this cover plate. I'm going to get a very tiny flathead screwdriver and reach into these little slots and just work on it. So I'm sorry if I cover up what you really want to see with my hands, but I have to work in here on both of these 2 slot holes and get this part disassembled. Ah, there we go. It's just starting to move. Okay, finally, this is not easy to get apart. I had to pry with a very thin screwdriver on the 2 ears, and then finally pulling on the backside, I was able to snap it out. But of course, anytime you touch anything like this, you void the warranty. But our equipment is so long out of warranty, it doesn't matter. Right here inside, you can see the 2 solar panels. There's 1 tab, a 2nd, and a 3rd for lining the panels back onto their seat. It's so black, I'm sure you can't see it. I'll bring this light in. Maybe that'll help some. You see by my left or my right thumb, there's a hole there, and 1 on the bottom. So they line up with their respective projections. So we'll fold the solar panel down, and we can just pop out these 2 batteries. It's a battery assembly. It's not like in a flashlight or a camera or a watch. These are all soldered together, and you buy them as a unit like this. And there's a small clip and a socket where it then slides in, and it takes really 2 tiny screwdrivers to take it out. There we go. And this is the battery assembly. So it all goes in one unit. And you just align the plug into the slot. And push with a very small flat head screwdriver. It just pops right in. Fold the solar panels back down. Oh, have to make sure all the wires are out of the way underneath. And get the projections lined up with the three holes in this black plate. And then you can snap it back together. Find all of your little marks on the bottom. One, two, and three. Okay. And snap it back together. And you put the four screws back in. And you're ready to put it back on top of the mast. After putting everything else together. Okay, thanks for watching. If this was helpful, please give us a thumbs up there on the screen and follow, and we'll see you next time as soon as I get this all back together.